Oh, hang on here. Oh, oh man. That's more beer. Yeah, it's Friday. Veterans Day. Armistice Day in Europe. 11-11. The 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, Germany surrendered. In a boxcar that eventually Hitler would force France to surrender in 1940, I believe it was. Yes, 1940. Anyways, why I'm making this video, is it for this? This first edition Gem Mint Solemn Judgment from Metal Raiders. This card is an interesting history. When Solemn Judgment was out, of course, originally, second set ever printed, Metal Raiders, people didn't like it. Pay half your life points, that's quite the price. That's a lot of money. Or life points, I mean, money, whatever. But the card eventually became better and better, and at one point it finally became at 3 because it was so good late game. I mean, what's late game, you only have 2,000 life points. You can negate their entire play. You can negate their Monster Reborn. You can negate their normal summon. You can negate whatever for 1,000 life points and you win. Solemn Judgment gets better as the game goes on. You do not want to see this at the beginning of the game. You want to see this towards middle and the end. So, I'm glad it's at 0. I think it could go to 1. If we also limit strike, I would be okay with 1 judgment, 1 warning, 1 strike. I think that would be fair. But Solemn Judgment's the big boy. He's the OG. He's the one that started this whole Solemn thing, of course. You got warning, Solemn strike, Solemn authority, Solemn scolding. And, or maybe authority is scolding. I can't remember. But there's a few of them now, and they're all good. It's just Judgment. It's the best, and why it's banned. No, that's not why I made the video, even though I love that card. It's for another one of these. The third box of Invasion Vengeance. So last time I was able to get a dimensional barrier out of it. Hoping to get a totally awesome, or another dimensional barrier. I'm not going to cry if I get another dimensional barrier, unlike all those people in the streets about Trump. You know, crying in the streets not going to, you know, do anything. I mean, it's too late. Try again in 4 more years. That's all you can do. I mean, if you don't like them, which is fine, you know, as long as you are controlled about not liking them. I mean, setting things on fire is only making them more popular. But if you just, you know, just 4 more years is all you got to wait. I mean, I waited 8 years to get rid of Obama, you know, and stop Clinton coming in. You know, you could always have to wait 4 years. I waited 8. I had a chance, and we lost, and we won this time. So, regardless, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Yu-Gi-Oh's all the time. It's for all of us. You know, I mean, there's no debate on it. Yu-Gi-Oh! Is the best card game. I don't care what anyone says. I will not debate them on that. It's, sir, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is better than Pokemon, the card game. I do like some of the Pokemon artwork on their cards, but the game is really slow and boring. Same with Magic. It's so slow. Yu-Gi-Oh! Is so fast. The action is just up the ass. So anyways, let me get this open. Get some more Invasion Vengeance. Right from the factory. Yes, indeed. Remember that Metallica song I haven't heard in years came on the radio all of a sudden? It was, Am I Evil? Yes, I am. Am I evil? I am man. I haven't heard that song in forever, and it came on the radio. All right, I love the green. I love the green sets. They look so green and blue. Ooh. All right. Here we go. I'm all good stuff. Oh, yeah. Got a Super Koi Koi and King Synchro. It's actually a pretty cool Synchro card. It really lets, I think it lets you Synchro twice with that. Yeah. Have not gotten the cover monster yet, the Starving Venom Dragon. which originally this set was called Invasion Venom, which I believe they changed the name because there just weren't any Venom cards. Burnout and Palazoic Opabemia. I have not yet played against the Palazoic deck. Don't know if I want to. Sounds like they're pretty weird. I'm going to Boston tomorrow, so I'm leaving the comforts of West Coast and heading straight for the East Coast. Seahawks at Patriots, that's where I'm going. Looking forward to the Seahawk game. Primeval Whimwitch and Teller Knight Genesis. What kind of Teller Knight monsters are on here? I can't even tell. There's Clyford, looks like there's Shadals. Like, this is like the crystal one. The one that was using Trishula's armor. Trishula was in a lot of cards for a while there. It was on Shadals and it was on Necroz, of course. Alright, what else do we got here? Raffi, Rosemary, and Subterra Nemesis Archer. Another Subterra Nemesis Archer. That's pretty good secret. I like it. I don't like how she's an elf. Was a Nemesis Warrior an elf? I don't think he was. She's got a little bird down here. She's got her quiver of arrows. I think she's going to need more than those little arrows to take out the behemoths, but I might be wrong. Maybe they're like that black arrow, that big black arrow that they used to take out that dragon, the Smog, whatever his name was. I can't remember the name of the dude who shot the arrow. He played that really shitty vampire movie, too, the Dracula. I guess I didn't go and see it, but people told me it was really bad. Red Eyes Inside, and there's a Subterra. Subterra Behemoth Stigokraken. Who left an ocean in the middle of the planet is a good question. I mean, how'd it get there? Now I can't get that Metallica song stuck out of my head. I can't get this pack open. There we go. Am I evil? Yes, I am. Of course, I can't sing like James Hetfield. Sometimes James Hetfield sings really well, and other times he sings really bad. Space Dragster, and oh, another Metal Foes Mithrilium. I have pulled so many of these. It's ridiculous. Like, how many of these Mithrilium am I going to get? What is this, number four? I think it's at least number four, maybe five. But I'm getting a lot of them. There's Realm Metal Foes. I'm not in a Pendulum deck. The only Pendulum deck I ever played was Clyford, and just because I love that whole thing where you tribute someone's stealth over a Helix and a Carrier, and you get three effects and they couldn't respond to, is so good. Gradle Combat Headshot. Flower Carding Board Fly and Spiral Resort. I wonder if Spirals or Subterras will ever be, like, respected in the tiers of Yu-Gi-Oh. You know what I'm talking about, where it's like, even if they're not the best deck, or second, or third best, at least it's somewhere it's like, ooh, Subterras, this could be bad. Like I think the deck now it's like that is, that card felt really thick, but I guess it's not. Is, Mermails? Yeah. Got, Whimwitch and Full Metal Foes Fusion. I love the artwork on that. It's so bright and colorful. But yeah, Mermails seems to be the deck right now, at least for a year or so, where it's like, ooh, this could be challenging. And then, I don't know if I've lost to Mermails recently. I know that when they came back and people were using that Atlantean Prince, said the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, I was playing Cosmo, and they really couldn't deal with Cosmo. I mean, I still think to this day, if Cosmo's at full power, even ABCs could not handle Cosmo. Oh, that's the first one of this. This is basically a super, a Fairy Tale Sleeper. Subterra Behemoth Burrowing, and Vola Chemicritter Methy Draco. Meth. There's Sprite's Blessing, Ignites Unite. Yeah, there's just a lot of, I don't know, like, the main decks right now, of course, are ABC, Metal Foe, and I guess Burning Abyss. Who would have thought Burning Abyss, more than 2 years later, would still be in the top three decks? I guess Blue Eyes has turned into the deck where it's kind of like, oh man, here's Blue Eyes. I mean, that's all I played against for like a month was Blue Eyes, it seemed like. Spiral Mission Assault and Spiral Master Plan. There we go, getting some spiral action. I tried making spirals and I couldn't get it to function at all. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Like, there's no win condition. Like, how do I win with this deck? I'd like to know, Konami. Please help. Here's Oxyox. Or OxyClean. Super Samurai Soul Peacemaker and Cyberlander Varash. Got that rare metal foes. I got like the new metal foe. Like, she's joined. I don't know if it's like he or she, but they've joined. Like, they brought her on as extra power. They're not really sure about her because she has an effect and none of them do. Alright. Keep it on going here. Constellar Tempest and Denglong! First of the Yang Zing. This is a good looking card. It's got like a ghost background, but it's actually got clouds and stuff. First of the Yang Zing. Yep. I pulled one of these guys at Sneak Peek. And people went crazy for him. They immediately took him from me. And I'm glad I have another one. Two Ultras, one Secret. So that's perfectly normal. That's how the new box is supposed to be. Two Ultras, one Secret per side. If you get a really good box, you get five Ultras and two Secrets. Or an amazing box, you get four Ultras, three Secrets. Hopefully all of the Secrets are good. Alright. Moving on. Got Spiral Mission Assault and another Chemicritter Methy Draco. More meth. What was that show people told me to watch back in the day? Breaking Bad Benjamin or something? No, Breaking Benjamin was like a band or something. Maybe it was just Breaking Bad. I don't remember. It had the dad from Malcolm in the Middle. He was like, they always showed him like staring at things. Like, I don't know if he was supposed to be high or what was going on, but people said that show's got a lot of meth in it. And I was like, well, I'm not into meth. I don't use drugs, but no, you gotta check it out. I never did. Okay, I'm not into TV. Angelica, Nine Pillars of Yang Xing, and Spiral Resort. A lot of Spiral cards in this box. I seem to have gotten a lot of Spiral. I still can't believe that was, I think this is Denglong there. He's already getting artwork in another. And that's Zephra, too. That was the one Zephra thing that people were into for a little while there that never really got off the ground. I played against a few Zephra decks quite a few times at the shop, but I always beat them. Again, I was playing Cosmo, so that may be a reason. Alright. Flower Cardian Clover with Boar. With Boar, like Bebop. Saber Reflection and Criston Emitrix. Super rare Criston. Last box I got seemed to have a lot of Criston cards. This one's got a lot of Spiral cards. I still can't get the Metallica song. I need to get For Whom the Bell Tolls stuck in my head. But I'm not too big into the lyrics in that song. That's all about. Oh, there's Fairy Tale Sleeper. That's two in one box. Got a Polychemicritter, Deoxogre, and Dark Requiem XYZ Dragon. For a second, I thought it was totally awesome, but no, I got fooled. I like its wings. It's like stained glass, like you'd find in a church. See, this is what they're using to rank up, I believe. XYZ Dragon, the normal one. Dark Rebellion XYZ Dragon into this with that new. I haven't gotten that card in out of this box, but the Phantom Knight rank up castle launch. That's cool. I haven't gotten that card yet. The Dark Requiem XYZ. Requiem for a Dream. Remember that? Remember when that song was like in every single video for a while? This is like back in 2005, 2006, 2007. Butterfly card. Super Heavy Samurai Ninja Saratubi. And there it is. The Phantom Knights Rank Up Magic Launch. That's what you use on Dark Rebellion XYZ Dragon once you use Break Swords Grave Effect. And then you use this to get that guy. The new Dark Requiem XYZ. This seems to be the first card in almost every pack. Criston Rosenix. I really wonder if Criston's can be cool or not. Permafall Seal Eel. Clyforce End and Torquetoon Gear. Which I actually saw somebody had in their top 8 deck for ABC. They did run a Torquetoon Gear. Okay, let's see if I get Criston Rosenix again. First card. Three in a row? Three? No, I got some. This card's frightening looking. I didn't notice how weird this card was looking. But look at this thing's mouth. Like, holy fuck. What is that? I don't know, but it's gross. Got Smiger, Flower Cardian Boardfly, and Criston Quan. Wouldn't be a Invasion Vengeance without getting that guy. I mean, I get that super all the time. Weird-ass monster. A Earth Fiend, which is relatively uncommon. Just a few of them, I think. What's his name's one? Fiendish Rhino. Yeah, he's Earth Fiend. Seal Eel. Super Samurai Soul Peacemaker, and another Phantom Knight's Rank Up Magic Launch. I wonder if this regular old Phantom Knights will ever be good, in case something really bad happens to Burning Abyss. Like they banned Dante. Banned Dante, that's crazy talk. I can't imagine Yu-Gi-Oh! Without Dante now. I guess it's something I have to get used to if they did, but I wonder if you could just make a regular good old Phantom Knight deck that would actually work. We got Cyphering Multithreader, Meteor Dragon, Red Eyes, Impact, and King Synchro. I can't tell if that's Kaiba or not. I think that might be Kaiba. Or Jack. I don't know. Maybe it's Zane. Maybe it's Chaz. It's certainly not Bandit Keith, though. I can tell you that much. Or Maximilian Pegasus. Oh man, this pack did not like opening. Am I evil? Still got that stuck in my head. Charming Resort Stats and Pod of Acquisitiveness. I always enjoy getting this. This is a good ass super to get. You know, supers are pretty much worthless now ever since they went from super in every pack. But Twin Twisters, of course, is the one where that's not the case. And this one's kind of that way too. It's a good super, but it ain't no Twin Twisters, I can tell you that much. But it's starting to see some play again, I saw. Or not again, but for the first time. Again, I saw a deck that used it. Another ABC deck, I think. And maybe a Shiranui. So people are testing it out, and some people are telling me it's really good. Frostfreeze. Predaplant Flytrap and Toon Torque Gear. Huh. Whoa. Alright, I think this is my last pack right here. I don't know if I've gotten all the ultras or not. I think I'm missing one. I think I may have only gotten three if this one's got an ultra in it. I don't remember. I'll have to count them up. Oh, my stack just fell. Here we go. Dragon Core Hexer and Subterra Behemoth Ultra Mephist. There we go. There's another. So I got two of the Subterra cards. I got a Behemoth, Ultra Mephist, and the Archer. I need to get a Stigo Kraken as well. I think I got the trap card too. Yeah, I got one burrowing. Alright, let's see what I got here. So I just got the Ultra Mephist. That's cool. Pile of Quizness. Always got to stop on that for the super. Got the Dark Requiem XYZ Dragon. That's pretty cool. Dang Long, first of the Yang Zing. Metal Foes Mithrium. Subterra Nemesis Archer. And you know what? I did only get three Ultras. This is a terrible box. Only three Ultras. One of them was this that nobody wants. Ultra Mephist, that's one. I did get two secrets. One. Two. Three. That's all I got. I only got three. Wow. Three ultras and two secrets. What a terrible box. Oh well, I'll take the Subterra Nemesis Archer. I like how this is an update of the sneak peek card for Duelist Alliance. When she was a teenager, now she's an adult woman slaying dragons. She don't even know why. Now she's cursed by killing that many dragons. I like how Konami brought back, like, you know, stories for all of its characters and stuff. But I don't know what the winner is. I don't know how much Requiem is worth. I have no idea. I know Nemesis Archer is about, what, $15? Maybe 20. Probably 15, though. Whatever. I've got them. And, guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry that the box wasn't that good. I mean, I just pick them out at the shop, and, ooh, that was not a good box. Only 3 Ultras. I would have felt better if I had gotten 3 Secrets, 3 Ultras. And I'm like, oh, you know what? It canceled out. Or 5 Ultras, one Secret, but hey, it didn't work out that way. What can I do? What can I say? Anyways, I really hope you enjoyed the video. I always enjoy opening up these boxes, and I'll be in Boston. So everybody, root for the Seahawks. Hawks! All right, guys, I'm getting drunk every day. Hope you all are, too. Peace!